Plastic is everywhere, but what does that mean for us and for our environment? And does it make all this plastic a good thing or a bad thing? Hi, my name's Shaun. I'm a PhD student at the Centre for Sustainable and Circular Technologies at the University of Bath. My work is centred around plastic materials and looks at answering questions like this. Plastics can do a lot of things that other materials can't. They can be light, flexible and strong, see-through or colourful, and we can even make them bounce. Basically, we need plastics for a lot of the things we do every day. However, the production of plastics typically relies on limited resources such as crude oil, and also results in the emission of greenhouse gases and other pollutants. Then, we need to decide what to do with plastics once they've been used, otherwise they can have further impacts on wildlife and the environment. So, it's difficult to say whether plastics are good or bad, but there are definitely things we can do to help make them better. To do this, we need to look at how plastics are made and used and try to find areas for improvement. We can look at what materials and chemicals are needed to make different types of plastic, but also where these materials come from, how much of them is needed, and what processes are used to turn them into the plastics we see all around us. Once they've been made, we can think about what they're used for, how long they're going to last, and if they'll need maintaining or repairing. Then what happens when we can't use them anymore? Can the material be recycled or reused? Or what's the best way to dispose of them? This idea of looking at the effects that materials can have on the environment over their entire lifetime is called life cycle assessment. Once we can draw a full timeline for a material, we can look at the data for each point in the timeline and start to total up the environmental impacts for that material. These impacts can then be sorted into groups to help us consider things like greenhouse gas emissions, energy use, and effects on human health. We can use these results to see how different materials compare in different applications, allowing us to choose the material which is best for a specific job. We can also use the timeline to see which section of the life cycle causes the greatest impact. Once these problem areas have been highlighted, they can become the focus of further research. This cycle of assessment followed by improvement means that we can continue to use and develop the best materials possible, both for us and for our environment. So while there's no simple way of saying whether plastics are good or bad, tools like life cycle assessment can help make sure that future plastics are better and more sustainable.